what to bring to the MCAT. Hey there, future doctors. So you've made it to the grand finale of MCAT prep. Congratulations. But before you march confidently into that testing center, let's talk about the essential question of the day. What the heck do you even bring to the MCAT? I mean, besides your A game and the hope that you don't forget everything that you've learned the moment you see your first question. Let's talk about the do's and don'ts of packing your MCAT go bag to make sure that you don't get turned away on test day. Starting with the basics, what will your test center provide you with? Well, you're gonna get your own wet erase booklet as your scratch paper and a marker to write with. Just try not to doodle your way through the exam. I know it's tempting. You will also be assigned a locker to store your possessions that aren't allowed in the testing room. We'll get to what those are in a second. Finally, most test centers also provide you with earplugs or headphones. If they do, you cannot bring your own. Okay, so what should you bring to the MCAT? Well, the most important thing to bring is an MCAT accepted ID. That could be a driver's license or some other government issued photo identification. Really important, the name on the ID needs to match 100% the name on your MCAT registration, and it cannot be expired. Your ID, your eyeglasses if you wear any, and any medical devices are the only items that you can bring with you inside of the testing room. But there are other things that you can bring to the testing center and store in your locker. Here's what we recommend. First up, food and water. You are going to be testing for about 7.5 hours, and you need fuel for your brain. Bring non-perishable snacks to eat during your breaks. Number two, medications. It's pretty self-explanatory if you need them. Now remember, even if you store your phone in your locker, you cannot use it until you're completely done with your exam. And last but not least, don't bring any items that could potentially get you in serious trouble on test day, including laptops, tablets, notes, MCAT prep pages, or review books, earbuds, or headphones, unless your testing center clearly says that they allow them. And certainly don't bring your friends, family, or any other member of your MCAT support group. And there you have it. That is the MCAT survival guide on what to bring and what to leave at home on test day. Now, go forth, conquer those passages, and remember, even if you accidentally draw a smiley face instead of jotting down some equations, it's all part of the test day experience. Good luck.